Hello, Artonians, and welcome to I Haven't Moved Since the Last Episode, because I'm literally not doing anything other than recording this. So, hoo boy, when last we left off, I was in the midst of the second run-and-gun level, and last run-and-gun level, because I'm not going to deal with this shit after this. I literally just want all the coins. I just want how to get them in these two levels. So it'll make it easy for me to unlock my entire loadout. So I really just want to get through this level. This level's a piece of shit. Son of a bitch level. And get to the real game, which is all boss rush stuff. That's honestly why I love this game. It's because the bosses are really cool and unique. And the game knows where its strong suits are and doesn't focus on anything else. Damn it. Hard to do this while talking. I won't lie. That's not why I'm losing. I'm losing because I'm bad. Shit. I don't know how I slipped off that panel. See? Like I said. Losing because I'm bad. Because that had nothing to do with me talking. I wasn't even talking during that one. I just died. That's an idiot. God damn it. I predicted the future. I'm secretly psychic. Alright, here we go. Back to the farm. Luckily, this part I know how to do very well, as long as, I can keep my head on straight, you know? As long as I stay focused, I can run through this part like it's nothing. Because I've done this so many times in the past. Because this level sucks. And I was trying to get all the coins at one point. You know, I was trying to do a perfect run. Actually 100% the game. I didn't end up doing it, which is why I'm not doing it on this, show. But it does mean that at least the first two running gun levels, which is all I really need to get my loadout, I know very well. I actually at least attempted all of the running gun levels when I played this game on my own. God damn it, really? I just didn't get a lot of the coins in there. Fuck. Alright. Fine. I just gotta be perfect from here on out. And God knows I'm not good at that. Sure as hell ain't perfect. Right, these little bitches I can only step on once, so I gotta be careful about where I move. Okay, this one's the tricky one. There we go, nice. I managed to thread the needle on that one. Shit. Move back! I wasn't expecting it to turn back. Alright. Fuck running gun levels. Seriously. They're honestly not worth my time. And if I had the coins to unlock my loadout by now, I wouldn't be doing this. Damn it. How did I do it that one time? Or all of those times, actually. I did it quite a bit. Aha! Got it. I knew I could do it. I don't think the creator intended that to be possible. I think he thought that he wanted you to do specifically the parry to get that coin. Which I could do, but it's actually harder than doing it this way. And this way you get infinite tries, while the other way you only get one try, so this way is better in my opinion. I don't think it's what was intended, but hey, whatever. It works. Hey, if it works. What's that meme about throwing dynamite is not a martial art? There we go. Done for. Why did I do that? Well, shit. That was a waste of my life. Kind of like this entire series. Alright, there we go. Oh shit, it's this part. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't have any more of that powerful shot anymore. Oh well. At least I beat the boss. What am I supposed to do here? I don't think I can jump far enough. Okay, good. That would have really sucked if I died there. Glad I didn't. I think I got all the coins on that one. Yes, I did. Alright. So I believe that is enough to get my entire loadout, what I used to beat this game the first time. Which honestly makes the game a piece of cake. that's an exaggeration, obviously. It's still difficult. But, at least it'll make it pretty doable. So, welcome to How to Play Cuphead. I'm gonna show you the only successful build in this game. Actually, a lot of people will disagree with me on two of these choices, but the third one I think everyone will agree with me on. So I'm gonna first of all buy the Chaser. That's for when I don't want to aim. It's for when I don't want to play the game. Mainly it's for when I'm focusing on dodging, rather than trying to get hits in, and I can just get a couple in anyway. I'm gonna get the Spread Shot, because it deals a lot of damage up close. Which is great for me. And then I think everyone agrees the smoke bomb is the best thing in the game. It's the only thing worth equipping for the L button, because it just allows you to dodge like half of the attacks you normally would have a really hard time dodging. So yeah, I'm gonna put, let's see, I want to start most fights with this because I want it to because I want to be hitting them right off the start. So there's that. Let me see if I can figure out if there's a quick way to get to the super before I do anything else. Because if there is... Yep, there is, okay. Because if there is, I want to get that super before I even start the first fight. Here we go, alright. Welcome to the last part of finishing my loadout. This, I believe I can do in one try, but I guess we'll find out. This one, the weapon doesn't even matter. You just parry everything. This is like a parry. It's testing your parries. Which, I'm good enough at to at least be able to deal with these little bitches. Oop. Yeet. Oops. I almost fucked up there, because I was screwing around. I was trying to be fancy. Wombo combo. Wave dasher. That ain't Falco. Welcome to the show where I reference Smash memes every time I kill a ghost. Now that would be a lot of Smash memes. Luckily there are a lot of Smash memes. I just don't know them all.
Gosh, I didn't know how to thank you boys for saving me. Where are my manners? I didn't even introduce myself. I am known as the Legendary Chalice. Pleased to meet you. I was searching for magic and got trapped by those ghosts. Speaking of magic, please accept this gift. It should help. There are other mausoleums around Inkwell Isle. I just wonder.
Nice. There's an interesting theory that, the deal that each boss made with the devil is what gave them their power to fight in the first place, and what makes them a threat.
Dear me, you mustn't forget that magical super arts have to be equipped in the menu before use.
Oh yeah, I actually did almost forget that and go into the next fight without doing it. Thank you, strange cup lady. I appreciate it. Alright, so, now it's time for the game to really begin. We're gonna do this one first, because it's usually pretty easy. Ruse of an Ooze. Or as I like to call it, that time I got reincarnated as a slime. Have you ever seen that show? God, that thing is OP. Alright, I'm gonna use the tracer shots for now. Just because I don't wanna bother playing this one risky. Oops. I could probably take him out much quicker if I use the chip. If I use the red shot, but see, that's why the smoke bomb's useful. I'm receiving a call, which I was not expecting. Oh, I missed the last one. Damn. I missed the last one because I was getting a call and I was like, what the hell is that? This boss fight's probably the easiest one in the game. I'm gonna save my ultimate until the last phase because it's the only time when... Actually, to be honest, this one's almost never hard. I might be able to perfect this one, in fact, right now. I seem to be on track to do it. I mean, I shouldn't talk because I'm gonna end up jinxing myself, but... anyway, I think I should be fine. We go. I like how this game handles bosses where you don't like wait for a vulnerability or have to solve some puzzle. You just shoot them, but also they have really insane attack patterns at the same time. I love the way this game handles bosses. I think it's just a very well made game in general. What the fuck was that call about? Well, it wasn't from. It was from in town. Oh well. Alright, I'll check it out later. Doesn't matter. I'm doing a thing right now. I will call them back as soon as I have a chance. Probably between the episodes. But for now, we have 3.5 minutes left to this one. So, I'm gonna go down to here. I believe this is the carrot. Because the carrot's not super hard. He can be a challenge, I guess, at times. But once you have the good loadout, it's fine. I gotta remember how to beat this one. Here we go. Here we go. I'm actually staying pretty focused this time. I'm blowing through this even faster than I did when I did my practice run on this. I did a quick practice run. Just to see how quickly I could get the loadout, so that when I got to this point where I'm actually recording this, I would be ready to go right away. And so this is the results of that practice run. I'm actually apparently doing pretty well at this. This part you actually have to play just like Galaga, which if you've ever played Galaga, you know that, the strategy with Galaga is to, focus on dodging, keep your eye on the top of the screen, rather than on your character. This part here is easy, you just have to deal with, the projectiles by shooting them, and if you use the spread shot, you can hit him and the projectile at the same time, which is very useful, and then when he goes into that, psychic mode, as long as you keep moving, you'll be fine. There's usually not a thing still here at this point, damn it. There usually is not a projectile still on the screen by that point of the fight. So, I should have killed that projectile quickly. I think that was my mistake there. Because I got trapped between the projectile and his attack. Here we go. Boom! That's another one down. What's that, 2 now? And I only took 1 damage between both of them? Doing good so far. Alright. Alright. Nice. So, I'm doing very well so far. These bosses do get harder. They start off pretty hard, actually, but I'm just so used to these first two, because I've fought them a million times. What is this asshole doing?
Ruff. I'll be a monkey circle if I'm putting my moolah in the bank. For all I know, the devil probably controls the place, too. They'll never get a hold of my gold, because I spread it all around. And if some Joe happens to find a coin or two, good for him. That's what I say. Rump.
So you're fine with other people stealing your gold, as long as it's not the devil. Alright. Well, I'm glad, because I got some of your gold, and I'm gonna leave the rest alone. You can keep it, buddy. Alright. Boss number 3. Clip Joint Calamity. This is the first one I think I'm actually going to have some genuine hard time with. The reason being that, these boys is hard. They're not the hardest thing in the world, But they certainly aren't easy. Luckily, I already know the strategy. Oh, that's my timer. You know what that means. It means I'm going to, have to, stop this episode right after this attempt. So we're gonna see how far I get. So you'll notice I didn't do any parries there. That's because, the parry timing there is a little too quick for me. I could do it. I can pull it off sometimes, but, not reliably enough to feel safe doing it. I prefer to just play the safe route and, not go for the parry on those. Shit. Alright, so this one, one guy's blowing you towards the other one to keep you on your toes, and then the other one's launching projectiles. So what you gotta do here is just keep towards this guy so that the projectiles have a long time to get to you and you can predict where they're gonna go. And then just focus on positioning yourself such that you don't have to, like, actively dodge the projectiles too hard. Just like that. I think their timing got a little off this time. Usually they, always do the attacks together, but their timing is off now. This guy can wait a decent amount of time before he actually goes into the attack. Now this is the hard part right here, because, these things are really hard to dodge, all of them. All of them are a difficult thing to dodge. So I'm gonna switch to focusing on dodging here. And I'm gonna use the, smoke bomb. As will become a common theme in this playthrough, I'm going to use the smoke bomb to not have to deal with the boss. That's about the gist of the smoke bomb's purpose. I'm gonna hit him with the ult now because I don't think... no, this one's actually pretty easy. I'm gonna stick to doing regular attacks now. I will move to the ult when I get a hard one. Because I'm at low health. Alright. And... damn it! The coin got me, of all things! I was not expecting that coin. Alright, we'll see if I beat this on the second try next time. Until then, stay interesting.